Hello everybody. Today we will present to you the TECAR therapy, Tecartherapy. That is the acronym for resistive and capacitive energy transfer. I will show you how this technology works and how it could turn out to be very useful in certain conditions presenting in our rehab veterinary patients. Tecartherapy is a quite innovative instrument that in Italy has been progressively used more for the treatment of veterinary rehabilitation and sports medicine conditions. It is a technology that generates heat within the tissues of the body for therapeutic purposes. It is defined as an endogenous thermotherapy because the heat is not radiated from the outside, but is produced directly within the tissue through the application of a variable electric field at high frequency. Globus Vet is a leader in building technologies that can be adapted to many different conditions in rehab. Today we will use Tecarvet 4000. Tecartherapy involves the use of an active electrode placed in contact with the skin and a return plate on the opposite side of the treated area. There is always the interposition of a conductive cream between the handpieces and the patients. The energy then flows in between the conductive pieces, leaving the target structure in between them, where the therapeutic action is needed. The therapeutic effects of Tecartherapy are tissue biostimulation, relieving edema, and deep anti-inflammatory effects. The greater the intensity we set with Tecarvet 4000, the greater the load of electrical current that will be transferred to our patient, and the greater the amount of heat that the patient will perceive. Using different levels of intensity, we will target different therapeutic goals. It is possible to use low, medium, or high energy level. When using the low energy level or cold Tecartherapy, we stay around 30 to 35 degrees Celsius. Within the tissue, the machine does not produce any heat, but rather activates microcirculation, having an anti-inflammatory and biostimulating effect that enhances the metabolism of the treated area. When medium energy levels are used, there is a slight thermal effect that stays between 35 and 38 degrees Celsius. There appears to be a significant increase in tissue oxygenation, vascularization, and helps with the release of growth factors and improvement of the venular lymphatic outflow. In the end, at high energy levels, there is an increase of thermal effect that goes up to 42 degrees Celsius. With this modality, it exerts a profound myorelaxant action, and it is very useful in the case of chronic condition affecting tendons and joint capsules. This therapy can be performed in two distinct modalities, more precisely in such a capacitive modality or resistive modality. The capacitive modality is applied by using an isolated electrode, which is this one. And this modality acts mostly on the soft tissues that are in close contact with the electrode and that are rich in water content, like for example skin, connective tissue, blood, and lymphatic system and muscle. It is a great setting, especially useful for treatment that needs to be delivered superficially, while the resistive mode is delivered by a non-isolated electrode. This setting helps the operator to reach tissues that have a lower percentage of water inside them and a greater resistance to the passage of electric charges. It is an unbelievable helping technique when talking about bony changes, cartilage lesion, tendinous and ligamentous conditions. So, what could we treat with our Tecarvet 4000? There is a broad spectrum of conditions that can be treated with this machine, both chronic and acute ones, such as osteoarthritis, spondyloarthrosis, muscle sprains and strains, muscle contractures, trigger points, tendinopathies, inflammatory edematous conditions, hematomas, and contusions. Now let's go over a few practical examples of how to apply Tecartherapy on a dog. Here we have Valentina with her dog Bola. We will treat her because she was hit by a car about 3 years ago and she got injured on her right posterior tibia. We can have the dog on a sitting position, for example, or we can have her on a lateral recumbency with a soft bedding underneath. It is important for the return plate to stay in contact with the skin at all times. Be careful to put enough cream on it to allow the contact with as wide of an area as possible. It is not advised to use Tecar 4000 on sedated animals, as it is important to receive patient feedbacks at all times with regards to the amount of heat perceived. If during the treatment session the patient seems uncomfortable or nervous, decrease the amount of intensity using this part of the machine or stop the treatment. Let's perform a treatment session and understand how Tecar 4000 works and what are the main differences between resistive and capacitive technologies. A treatment session done using Tecarvet 4000 needs to have one electrode and one return plate at all times. It is important to ensure that return plate does not become too hot and it does not have to lay in contact with bony prominences. The energy will flow in between the electrode and the plate, allowing for treatment of the anatomical structures that are living and lay in between. The capacitive diatomy uses an active electrode covered with insulating material. In this particular circuit, the insulation material concentrates around itself all electrical charges, which therefore act in superficial tissues under the active electrode for the first 3 centimeters of thickness. These centimeters are those that are high in water and electrolyte content, such as muscle and blood vessels. In this type of therapy, it is recommended to move the active electrode circularly on the treatment area at the speed of 1 circle every 1-2 seconds to facilitate an optimal dispersion of electric charges to prevent overheating of the tissue. The return plate must be positioned on the opposite side to the one treated. The duration of each session is usually 15 to 20 minutes. The resistive diatomy uses 2 non-coated metal electrodes, the active electrode and the return plate. This way, the tissues of the patient represent the resistance at the passage of electric charges. The tissue more resistant to passage of the charges is the bone, since it is the least rich in water and electrolytes, followed by collagen-rich tissue like tendons and ligaments or joint capsules. The greater the resistance offered by the tissue, the greater the amount of charges accumulated and the heat that is produced. This way is recommended to move the active electrode circularly on the treatment area at a speed of a circle every 1 to 2 seconds to facilitate an optimal dispersion of the electric charges and to prevent overheating. It is necessary to keep in mind that the resistive mode, the electric charges are concentrated in the fibrous tissue that are often localized in the middle between the active electrode and the return plate, as this may be useful for deciding the placement of the electrodes over the patients. Now let's start placing a generous amount of cream on the electrodes. We will start from the plate and the electrode. We will start first with the capacitive technique, and the intensity, we will use a low intensity that goes up to 10 to 15%. The intensity is regulated with this round handle. So let's try this technique on Bola. Let's place the plate underneath the desired area that we want to treat. And let's make sure there is a good contact in between the plate and the skin with a lot of cream in between. The machine will beep until we reach an excellent contact in between the electrode and the patient. To check for any temperature overheating, you can certainly touch the patient's skin and make sure it doesn't get too hot. For the resistive mode, let's place a generous amount of cream on the plate and on the electrode. Let's seat the patient comfortably, possibly sitting down or lying on a side, depending on the area that we want to treat. Let's pass the plate over to a technician, or you can do it yourself. Make sure there is a good contact between the patient and the plate with enough cream in between, and put the intensity up. The machine starts beeping as soon as you put the intensity up and will stop as it reaches a good contact. Let's move the probe in circles at a speed of 1 to 2 seconds per circle. This is how the equipment that is given to you looks like. You get 2 electrodes, 1 capacitive and 1 resistive, 1 plate, and then you have 3 different sizes, both for each resistive and capacitive technologies. This is the small one, you get the medium one, and the large one that can be used for wider areas, bigger dogs, or even for horses. Now enjoy watching it.